miss this reminder on this particular day. I was invited to do a concert in a place that was not as beautiful as this beautiful new building. There were no fancy lights, no merchandise displays or smoke machines. I was invited inside the walls of a maximum security prison. I wish I could tell you that I was the picture of courage that day. But that was not the case. I was nervous. I was scared. And I remember the security guards, they were searching me before allowing me inside the prison. And they took my Bible away from me. And I guess it is a sword, a weapon, but I don't know why they took it away. And my fear did not subside. And finally, they led me inside, and I took a step inside the walls of the prison. And just as I did, the prison chaplain ran up to me. And he had this big smile on his face. He said, "Oh, Matthew, I'm so glad you're here. I've got some great news. I've just talked with the warden. And he's decided to allow you to sing your songs in an area of the prison where they never allow any visitors." Awesome. Thank you, Lord. My voice started cracking like the kid on the Brady Bunch, and he wasn't kidding. They walked me into the solitary confinement unit, and I couldn't see my audience that day. I was standing in an empty room facing two stories of cell doors, and they weren't the cell doors at the county jail with the bars. They were cell doors that were just ironclad. Each cell door had a tiny window in the left-hand corner, and my fear did not go away. And I stood there with my guitar, and my introduction was not an impressive one. It was this big burly security guard, and he stood up, and I'll never forget, he said, "All right, listen up. There's a guy here who's going to sing some songs. You can listen or not. But don't make any noise or else." And then he looked at me and said, "Good luck." I've written hundreds of songs in my life. This is no joke. In that moment, I couldn't remember the words to a single song. So I remember praying a silent prayer. There was an awkward silence because I had some talking to God to do. And I remember my prayer was something like this: "God, you better show up here, because I got nothing." And you know what I've come to find? Maybe you've come to find this in your own life. That's probably one of God's favorite prayers to hear from his children. When we finally admit that apart from God, what do we got?
Nothing.
We got nothing. And he showed up and he put some words in my heart and in my mind. And they were these words: "There is no guilt here. There is no shame. No pointing fingers. There is no blame. What happened yesterday has disappeared. Some dirt is washed away. Now it's clear." With my eyes closed, I just sang, "There's only grace, there's only love, there's only mercy, and believe me, it's enough. Your sins are gone without a trace. There's nothing left enough. There's only grace." I opened my eyes, and I could see my audience that day for the first time. One by one, faces began to appear from behind those cell doors and those tiny windows, and I saw the faces of those inmates looking at me. And I was struck with a powerful reminder that we all sin and we all fall short of the glory of God. A buddy of mine goes to those prisons all the time and speaks to them. And the first thing he says to the inmates when he meets them is, "Hey, the only difference between me and you is you got caught." In a way, it's true. As the Bible says, all have sinned and all fall short of the glory of God. We all need forgiveness. We all need God's grace. And standing in that prison is a powerful reminder that there's no prison you and I could create for ourselves that could stop the pursuit of God's love and his grace in our lives. Are you thankful for that? That God pursues us and helps us get back up. Would you guys stand with me? Can you lift your voices with me and we'll sing this? Amazing grace, how sweet.